I hope you all are fine and doing well. So let's start our next topic in the chromatography series, that is the paper chromatography. So I'm using, particularly for this concept, I'm using the notes from the nkpatel.co.in, because I personally found these notes very, very useful. Okay, so I acknowledge this website, these notes, for education purpose. So I respectfully acknowledge this. So let's start paper chromatography. So first thing came into our mind is paper. Do we use ordinary paper? No. Yes, there is a specialized paper of Wattman, or you can say the Wattman filter paper, specially made filter paper for this chromatographic setup. So we cannot use the ordinary filter paper for the paper chromatographic analysis. We have to use the specialized paper that is meant for the paper chromatography, like in this way. Just see what happened when I write in the Google images, that is paper chromatography filter paper, and I click on the images part. You can see, so these all are the pictorial representation of the paper chromatography. So you can this, just see this color, because we know the chromos mean the color, chromatos mean the color. So separation, yes, separation take place. Okay, the separation, we will see separation in the paper chromatography, and we need a specialized papers like in this way. These are the specialized paper meant for the paper chromatography. So just see this chromatography paper strip. Okay, so let's start the concept of the paper chromatography. So it is defined. So first of all, it is depend upon, or it is based upon the principle of the, yes, you all are right, partition. Okay, it is based upon the principle of the partition. And we know in the partition chromatography, the substances are distributed between the two liquids. And one is the stationary liquid, which is held in the fibers of the paper. That is called as the stationary phase. So sometimes in the question, in the examination question, might ask, what is the stationary phase in the paper chromatography? So we'll say paper, no, because we know paper chromatography is what? It is a partition chromatography, and here it is written distribution between the two liquids. So where it is, where it, the second liquid is, just read it carefully. One is stationary liquid that is held in the fibers of the paper. So yes, we can say that in the paper chromatography, stationary phase is the liquid, or the stationary liquid which is held in the fibers of the filter paper, or the paper, specialized paper meant for the paper chromatography. And the mobile phase, yes, is a solvent, is your moving phase. Okay, and the component of the mixture to be get separated, because they migrate at different rates and appear at different RF values. So I hope you know about the partition coefficient. So I request you to again go by the video partition coefficient, and then watch this video of paper chromatography, because the principle of the paper chromatography is based upon the principle of partition coefficient. So let's see the types. Yes, the descending chromatography. This is the paper descending chromatography. Just first of all, just see the images and we will go them one by one. Okay, ascending chromatography, just see this image. This is the ascending chromatography. This type of apparatus, this type of assembly that is present in our laboratory also, that in the pharmacology laboratory. Okay, third one is the ascending descending both. Fourth one is a radial. I hope, because I have completed this topic in the seventh semester also, that is the paper chromatography. Some of the practicals we have done of the students of the seventh semester. So this is the radial. Okay, or sometimes known as a circular also. And this is the two-dimensional, here it is. That's why I found these notes very, very important, because in particular in these notes, all the diagrams are also given, which I found very fruitful. Okay, so these are of five types again. Just go back again. Descending, ascending, then ascending, descending, then the radial, and last is the two-dimensional. Just see here, this is the descending order. In this way, descend. So in descending chromatography, when the development of the paper is done by allowing the solvent to travel down the paper. Okay, this is known as the descending technique. Please see this diagram. That is, so in descending chromatography, yes, we need to place a solvent here. So hole for introduction of the introducing the solvent is in this way. Okay, and this hole is your particularly, this is the paper. Here it is the your paper, and this is a support rod. This is your support rod, and this is the sample spot, suppose. Just see this. This is the developing solvent. It's a cover, tank cover. Developing solvent you would put here. This is the paper support. Here you can apply your test sample. And in this way, the filter paper, specialized filter paper meant for the paper chromatography, is hanged inside your this developing tank. This is whole assembly is closed. Okay. So in this way, this is the descending type of paper chromatography. Next one is the ascending chromatography. Yes, when the development of the paper is done by allowing the solvent to travel up the paper, is known as the ascending one. Just see this setup. This is the whole your paper chromatography chamber, and in this here you will put your mobile phase downwards. Only then the capillary reaction will achieve and the spots will move upward your paper. Just see, this is ascending. So in this way the solvent is here, then you will put your spots with the help of capillary, fine, very fine capillaries used, and in this way the capillary reaction is achieved. The direction of the solvent flow in this direction, in upwards. Okay, and this is the filter paper. Yes, the solvent tank is there. This is the solvent front. Please go by the video of TLC. We have already covered the solvent front, the RF value. I have cleared all your doubts. And this is the place you have to basically the clips to attach your paper. Yes, so this is ascending order. So the third one is the ascending descending. This is the combination of both. Look at this. It is a hybrid of both the techniques. In this, the upper part of the ascending chromatography can be folded over a glass rod, allowing the descending development to change over the ascending across the glass rod. So in this way, suppose this is the upper part, okay, of the ascending chromatography. Suppose this is your ascending chromatography upwards, and this upper part is basically folded on a glass rod, and this is again your paper. So in this way, this is ascending, and after that the descending chromatography is achieved. Okay, so very simple. You see this image again. This is the ascending flow. Here you can put your mobile phase, and the paper is fixed with the help of a glass rod. Just see here, ascending, descending. Next one is the radial, or sometimes known as the circular paper chromatography. So in this technique, we are using a circular filter paper. So these are commercially available circular filter papers of the Wattman grade. So remember this thing, in this type of chromatography, just see here, you have to apply the spot at this point, at this in a circular motion. And the movement of the mobile phase is like this, in this direction, from this to this. Suppose this is your circular, or it's a radial paper chromatography. So first of all, in this point you will apply the spots. Just see here, suppose I will select again a circle, and I will select, wait a second, in a circle here, and I will, first spot is suppose here, second spot is here, third one is, and fourth one. And the movement of the mobile phase, or you can say the solvent, is like this. In this way it will move. In this way it will, for second spot, this is third spot, this is suppose fourth, and this is fifth. So in this way you can achieve your separation. And what is your RF value? The distance at which your particular solvent will move. Suppose you have from this point. So from application spot to the actual point where the solvent moves is your RF value. I hope you know the difference between the concept of RF value is the distance traveled by the spot upon the solvent front to this point. This point to the, this point is known as the your solvent front value. Solvent front value. Okay. Please watch. I welcome you all in the part 2 video of the paper chromatography. So far we have covered the ascending paper chromatography, the descending paper chromatography, then ascending, descending, and we are doing the radial part. So please see again in this technique, in the radial paper chromatography, a circular filter paper is employed and the various material to be analyzed is placed on the center. Here is the application of the spot. Here will you apply spots at the center. Okay. Then after the application spots, after drying the spots, the filter paper is fixed horizontally on a petri dish, or you can say the pet dish, possessing your solvent. The solvent will carry, solvent will be present in your petri dish. Okay. And you will put a hole here for your wick. Okay. So that you can just see here, after drying of this spot, the filter paper is fixed horizontally on the petri dish possessing the solvent. Okay, I think this is clear. And then look at this, so that the tongue of the filter dips in the solvent. When the solvent front has moved through a sufficient large distance, the components get separated, forming concentric circle spots in this way. Look at this. Suppose this is your petri dish and you will place a mobile phase or solvent in this place, and your paper is here. And what is happening? Basically, you will prepare a wick. Please see this image. This is a radial paper chromatography. Here, this is a wick. First of all, just clear your meaning of wick. This is the candle wick. So you have to prepare the wick like this of your filter paper that are using in your paper chromatography. Okay. Suppose you have prepared this wick from your paper. What will happening? You will put your paper into this petri dish. This is your paper, and this is the point of your solvent. So you will place your wick in such a way by doing a center hole in your filter paper. Just see this. This is your wick, and this is the hole you have done in your filter paper. And here beneath there, this is the application of the spots. And due to this, this wick will carry the mobile phase, and it will then mobile phase will go in the radial direction or the circular direction. That's why this is known as the radial or circular paper chromatography. Just here, suppose this is a circular filter paper, and this is the point of your wick. This is a wick of your paper, and this wick is attached to the mobile phase. And with the help of this wick, the mobile phase is again to go inside this wick, and it will carry in the circular path, or it will follow a radial path, and your separation is achieved. So in this way, this is filter paper. Again, this is, you will draw this circle with the help of pencil. And suppose this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So here, using different spots are marked by the pencil, and you can see this is circular separation. You can see the circular path. Okay, just see here, original dot in ink position, this is the original dot of the ink, and here this ink dot gets separated into different colors. Okay, so don't worry, I will show you demonstration of this practical, of this particularly paper chromatography topic in the practical also. So next is the 2D chromatography or the two dimensional chromatography. So in this, a square rectangular paper is used, and the sample is applied on one of the corners. So see this, what is the main concept behind 2D chromatography? As sometimes it is difficult to separate a complex mixture of substances by a single run, or using a single mobile phase, or using a single solvent system. In such cases, a second run is carried out by different mobile phase, but here it is, in a direction perpendicular to the first run. Okay, just see here, suppose this is your mobile phase, and here you have drop of mixture in the corner of your paper, and you will see this mixture gets separated into different components. This is a separation table. And then what will you do? You will turn paper 90 degree clockwise and use a different mobile phase. So when you do that, you can see these components, they get separated from each other due to this rotation, that is of 90 degree clockwise rotation, the compounds get separated, or you can easily identify each and every component. So this is the logic behind 2D chromatography. So see again, in this, a square rectangular paper is used and the sample is applied on one of the corners. And the second development, in which you are using a different mobile phase, is performed at right angle of the direction of the first one. Okay? So this type of chromatography can be carried out with the identical solvent system in both direction or by using different solvent system. Suppose this is your rectangular filter paper that are using in the paper chromatography, and here in the corner you have applied your sample. And suppose the sample gets separated into these components 1, 2, 3, 4. And the next step is to rotate 90 degree clockwise. Please see the clockwise rotation. So in this way, yes, this is your clockwise rotation. So ultimately you will achieve this. Okay, you can apply spot here. After some time the separation take place, and then you turn the paper at the right. Okay, and the clockwise direction, you will see, with again run the paper with different solvent system, you will achieve the separation or identification of the different components present in this mixture. Because the aim of the chromatography is again to separate, identify, again to purify, and then to isolate. But chromatography is particularly used for the separation and identification purpose only. So let's see different experimental details of the paper chromatography. So first of all, choice of the proper chromatographic technique is important. So whether you are able to use the ascending, descending, or the both, or the circular, only depend upon your nature of the substances to be separated. Second, yes, the choice of the filter paper is also very crucial, whether we are using a particular grade of the filter paper or not. Okay, whether the paper is being used for the quantitative or qualitative analysis, whether it is used for the analytical purpose or the preparatory chromatography. Then this is quite important, selection of the proper development solvent. So choice of the mobile phase is the most critical step in the paper chromatography, because it will, and how it will totally depend upon the constituent you are going to be separated from a particular mixture. Okay, and we use different type of solvents in the paper chromatography. Like in this way, this is the N-hexane, cyclohexane again. Yes, the polarity index. Please go by the video polarity index. This is the order of the increasing polarity. N-hexane is the least one. It is the non-polar. And then this polarity chart increases. And methanol, then ethanol, methanol, water. Okay. Then fourth point is the separation of the sample. Yes, you have to prepare a particular sample that should be dissolved in a particular solvent. Then spotting is done with the help of your capillary. And yes, you will draw a particular marking with the help of pencil on your filter paper. Okay, like in this case of radial chromatography, yes, you will draw these spots first of all with the help of your pencil, and then with the help of capillary you will apply your sample over here. Even in this case also, you will apply your spots with the help of, first of all you will draw a line over here with the help of pencil, and then with the help of capillary you will put your spot here. Okay, so the next point is, after spotting, drying of the chromatogram. You will dry your chromatogram and you will visualize it by using different methods, like physical and chemical method. In the physical method, we generally use, yes, UV lamp, or you can say UV cabinet, but generally see our samples, see our spots in the UV light. And in case of chemical method, we use different type of detection or detecting reagents, or you can say the spraying or the dipping reagent solution. And it will also depend upon the sample that you have to analyze. Yes, there are a number of applications are there of paper chromatography. It is widely used for the qualitative analysis only, not the quantitative analysis. It is the use for the qualitative analysis of what? Inorganic and organic, and the biochemical testing or the biochemical molecules. It is widely used in the separation or the analysis of the mixture of amino acid and also mixture of sugars. So it is chromatography, that is the paper chromatography, is widely used for the separation of, or you can say for the analysis or the identification of I welcome you all in the third video or the third part of the paper chromatograph. So in this video, we will just go over an overview of the paper chromatography again, because we have completed the entire process in the part 1 and part 2 video. So suppose this is a paper strip that is particular length 2.5 into 10 centimeter strip of the paper, and this is specialized paper. Suppose in this case, it is made up of on cellulose filter paper of particular grade, and here is a developing solvent, developing chamber is there. So you will put a sample spot here, and we know the sample is always a mixture that is to be analyzed. Okay, and then in this case, this mixture is get separated into different colors. Suppose we have three colors, that is the yellow, or you can say, suppose in this case, yellow, pink and blue. So you will calculate the RF value of these three components or the three compounds using a simple formula, that is the distance traveled by the individual component or the sample divided by the distance traveled by the solvent front. And I hope you know the value of the solvent front. So upon the distance for the application spot up to the place, up to the point where your spot, or you can say where your solvent will run. So at this point, this is the value of your solvent front and this is the value of your spot. And what happened, particularly in the paper chromatography, we do not achieve a proper separation. So what we assume, we will assume a middle value. Suppose this one is your this one is the distance traveled by from this point to this point is the yellow, and we will consider a value that is in between this whole point. Okay, so we will consider a round of value, approximate value from this point up to the center of this point. Okay, and suppose for blue, just see this. Suppose this, from this point, you will, the mixture gets separated into blue component from this to this. And we will consider the point at from somewhere in the middle. Always remember one thing, somewhere in the middle we have to select a point. Because in paper chromatography, again I am saying, we do not able to see the exact, or you can say the prominent or the proper separation. We cannot able to see. We do not able to see any spots get separated into particular components. Okay, we will just able to see a particular line that is only applicable in case of amino acid, where in some cases, yes, we able to see some particular spots. But in most cases, we are going to see this line, and what we have to do, we have to mark, we have to select a center or the mid value for calculation of our RF value. Okay, I think this is clear. Suppose this is your paper chromatography and here is your spot, and you will see this is your first color. Suppose this is first separation, and here this is your second separation, and just by blue this is your third separation. So what will we do for the calculation of RF value? Suppose for RF value of blue compound, what will you do? You will select a middle value. You will calculate the distance with the help of scale, and you will select a middle value that will be for your RF. Same in case of this yellow one, yes, you will select a middle value. The same in this case of red one, we will select a middle value. Okay, so that's why this is only the preliminary study, and it will only give a qualitative estimation, only for the quality, not the quantity. Yes, and it is applicable for, widely used for the amino acids as well as for the detection of carbs, carbohydrates. I think this is clear. Okay, so again I am saying, I will also make another part of paper chromatography from different book, from a particular reference book. So these are the references that I have used to prepare the part 1 video, part 2 video and this video of the paper chromatography. So I acknowledge all the resources that I have used to prepare this video, and I respectfully acknowledge all the resources. So this video is only intended for education purpose. I also request you all, do not share this video in any other electronic platform, because it is strictly prohibited, as it is only made for you purpose, for the education purpose, and for you, that is the students. Thank you for your valuable time. and your patience. Keep reading. I hope you all are fine and doing well. So let's start our next topic of discussion, that is in the paper chromatography series, the notes from respected Dr. G.R. Chatwal. So in this video tutorial, we are going to cover the notes from the book of the respected author Dr. G.R. Chatwal from the instrumental method of analysis. So we are going to cover the paper chromatography concept from this book. So first of all, I acknowledge Dr. Chatwal for giving us valuable and these fruitful notes. And this book is very, very important, and I highly recommend this book for the chromatography part. Okay, so let's start. I hope we have covered some of the aspects of the paper chromatography, and I hope you all are familiar with this. So the principle involved in the paper chromatography is, yes, the partition. So just see this introduction part. Cellulose filter paper is oftenly used. So as I've told you earlier, there are different type of, we cannot use an ordinary filter paper for the paper chromatography purpose. We have to use a specialized filter paper, and most of them are made up of cellulose, and there are different type of Wattmann filter papers that are available commercially in the market, especially for the paper chromatography. Okay, so this is important, because always remember one thing: for chromatography we need majorly two things, stationary phase and mobile phase. So what is the stationary phase in TLC? Yes, we know in case of thin layer chromatography we are using a solid material that is known as the adsorbent when we talk about the normal phase. So in case of paper chromatography, let's see what is the paper mobile phase in the paper and the stationary phase in the paper chromatography. Just see this. Since the paper is hydrophilic, we all know that the paper, they will absorb moisture. So it is usually covered with a thin film of water and is often regarded as a liquid chromatography. So I hope you have idea about the partition coefficient, because in partition coefficient we have covered this concept of the liquid chromatography, because the compounds which is present in the mixture, they get partitioned between the two liquid phases, and that is happening in the paper chromatography also. Okay, just see this. Special papers are used. Okay, and the credit of the paper chromatography goes to the Cambridge School of Workers, A.J.P. Martin and his co-workers. So the principle involved in the paper chromatography is partition, in which, yes, here it is, the substances are distributed between the two liquids, substances that are present in a mixture or in a sample. So they are distributed between the two liquid. One is the stationary liquid, and other, look at this, stationary liquid which is held in the fibers of the paper is called as stationary phase. So most of the students are sometimes confused when I ask question, what is the stationary phase in the paper chromatography? So most of the students say, yes sir, it is the paper, but it is incorrect. So what is the stationary phase in the paper chromatograph? Here it is written. You can say that the water molecule adhered by the fibers of the filter paper is the stationary phase in the paper chromatography. Remember one thing, that's why it is known as the liquid chromatography, or the, look at this, it is the liquid chromatograph. Again, see this, in this type of chromatography, substances are distributed between the two liquid. One is a stationary liquid, that is usually water, but where, which is held in the fibers of the paper and is known as the stationary phase. Whereas the moving liquid, or you can say the developing solvent, in which we are using different type of solvents, are used as a mobile phase. Okay, and yes, the components of the mixture that to be separated, they migrate at different rates, and they appear at different points, and yes, we will calculate the RF value in this case also, same in case of TLC. So I hope this is clear about the stationary phase and the mobile phase in case of paper chromatography. Stationary phase is nothing but it is the liquid adhered by the molecule of adhered by the filter paper, whereas the mobile phase is we are using the different type of solvents. So let's see this. This is RF value. I hope we have covered this. Distance traveled by the solute or the sample or the spot divided by the distance traveled by the solvent front from the original line. Let's see this. Suppose this is the point of origin where you have put your spots, and always remember this thing, we will एटलीस्ट स्पेयर दिस डिस्टेंस एंड वी विल अप्लाई आवर स्पोर्ट्स हेयर. वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड दिस बिकॉज इफ यू अप्लाई स्पोर्ट्स हेयर वट विल हैपन, दे विल गेट डिसॉल्व्ड इन द मोबाइल फेज. That's why we will leave this distance of about 1 to 2 centimeter and apply our spots over here. Okay, so this is the point of origin and here is the solvent front. In paper chromatography, we cannot obtain a straight line. So we obtain this type of zigzag line in case of solvent front in paper chromatography. So suppose this line from original line to the solvent front, this point is known as the solvent front and this is the your center of this port. And I previously told you that we will take a distance about the center of the particular spot. Okay, so this is the RF value, that is the distance traveled by the spot divided by distance traveled of solvent front. So we have already covered this point also. In this book, there is very much information is given about the different types of paper chromatography. That is, first is descending one. I hope you have idea about this now. So this is the descending type, and in the descending type, look at this. This is the descending order. Due to gravity, the chromatogram develops. So here it is a paper. Here it is you are use a solvent. So it is solvent reservoir is top of your paper. Okay. Second is ascending type. This is normally we use in the laboratory, like same as the TLC. So here, this is the place where you will put your solvent, or you can say mobile phase. And here you can hang your paper with the help of different hooks. Okay. And here is the capillary action due to which the phenomena take place. Third one is the ascending descending. Again, this one is the ascending here, and this is descending. And in this specialized type of chromatography, you will put a glass rod here. Okay, so let's read it once. It is a hybrid type of two techniques, that is ascending and descending. In this technique, the upper part of the ascending chromatography, this one, can be folded over a glass rod. So this is folded over a glass rod, allowing the ascending development to change over into descending one. Okay, so solvent will rise in such a way, this is the mobile phase, and solvent will rise here and then it will go inside this. So first of all, it is ascending, and in this case, this is descending. So that's why ascending, descending type of paper chromatography. Okay. So next one is the radial paper chromatography. We have already covered this. Again, here you will apply your sample. This is the place for the wick where you prepare from this filter paper. These are specialized filter paper. And here you will mark a solvent front and you can calculate the RF value. Then very important 2D chromatography, 2D paper chromatography. This is widely used for the separation of the complex mixture in which two-dimensional chromatography is achieved. And how it is achieved? Yes, it is achieved by rotating your paper by 90 degree. Okay, and develop in the different mobile phase. I again request you please go by the previous video because we have already covered this. Okay, so next one in this book there is given, that is the experimental details of the quantitative qualitative analysis. So always remember one thing, paper chromatography is meant for only the qualitative analysis, not the quantitative analysis. Okay, so yes, there are different type of Wattman. Here it is, the different type of Wattman filter papers are available, like Wattman 20 2045, different type of 3 mm, they have diameter of 3 mm are available. So here is written different type of modified papers for paper chromatography. We use the carboxyl paper, acetylated paper, crystal gur, zirconia paper, silica paper, etc. Okay, and here it is the choice of the mobile phase that we are using in the paper chromatography, like n-hexane, cyclohexane, benzene, toluene. So this one is the polarity order. This is the non-polar, and here the polarity is increases. That's why water is the most polar one. Then again, the stationary phase is water, which is adhered by the filter paper, and here is the different type of mobile phase, like isopropanol ammonia water is frequently been used, like 9:1:2, and again n-butanol acetic acid and water. So these type of micropipettes are used for the spotting purpose in the paper chromatography. So for the detection, or we can say for the visualization, we use different methods like physical method using a UV light and calculation of RF values, and the chemical detection by using different spraying reagent. We have already covered this point also. Okay, next is the estimation after extraction from the paper. Just read this. The simplest procedure is to cut down the paper and soak into a particular solvent. So okay, so time is running, so we will do this part in the next video tutorial of the पेपर क्रोमेटोग्राफी. तो थैंक यू फॉर योर पेशेंस एंड लिसनिंग.